Hello, my name is Jason Johnson. Thank you for watching my videos. This video is going to be an example of the Raptor flowchart-based programming environment. In this example, we're going to be doing avoiding division by zero. And this is the example 4.16, displaying the reciprocal of a number avoiding division by zero. So one of the examples that we have to do, or one of the things that we have to do, is make sure that we're not dividing by zero, or we're going to select a reciprocal of a number. So the example that we're going to set up is the reciprocal of a number is a 1 divided by that number. So an example would be 8 is 1 divided by 8, and the reciprocal of 2/3 is 1 divided by 2/3 equals 3 over 2. So with a reciprocal of a fraction, we just flip it, interchange it, its numerator and denominator. And every number except for 0 has a reciprocal. We say that the reciprocal of 0 is not defined because there is no real number equal to 1 over 0. So the following program segment displays the reciprocal of the number entered by the user unless that number is 0, in which case it displays an appropriate message of we can't use this number or something along those lines, or the reciprocal of 0 is not defined. What we're going to do is we're going to write enter a number. We're going to write this program will display its reciprocal. Then we're going to have the user input a number, and we're going to say if the number is not equal to 0, and I wanted to give you an example down here because we've used equal equals before. The equal to operator returns true if both operands or both sides have the same value. Otherwise, it returns a false. The not equal to operator, which is a bang or exclamation equal sign, returns true if the operation or operands or both sides of the equation don't have the same value. Otherwise, it returns false. So this is a way to flip those. We can do an equal sign to say return true, or a exclamation equal sign to return true if the operand don't have the same value. So that's the difference between these two. I'm not sure if I've explained that in previous videos, but that's these two different operations. So what we're going to do is put this into Raptor. We're going to start the program. We're going to have the user, we're going to tell the user what we're doing. Enter a number. This program will display its reciprocal. We're going to set the variable of number. Then we're going to say, is the number not equal to 0? If the number is not equal to 0, so it's going to return the opposite value of an equal sign. If it is 0, it's going to come over here and say put the reciprocal of 0 as undefined. If it's not equal to 0, we get a yes. Then we're going to get a reciprocal is whatever 1 divided by the number that was put in by the user. And then we're going to output that to the user and say the reciprocal of their variable number is and what the reciprocal is. So let's run this real quick. We're going to say enter a number. Let's go ahead and put in 0 for the first time. And it's going to come and it's going to say the reciprocal of 0 is undefined, and it gives us that information. So let's run it one more time and let's put in, let's say 10. Let's put in a value of 10. And it's going to say, nope, it's not a 0, so it's going to come over here. And it's going to say the reciprocal of 10 is 0.100000. And we've run 6 symbols on this. All right, so this video was avoiding division by 0. Example 4.16, displaying the reciprocal of a number. And if you have any questions, you can leave a comment below. For my students, you can email me at my email address in the course. Hope you have a great day. Stay safe and remember to be excellent to each other.